Hello! Welcome to another episode of Harry's Cocktail Adventures. Now, I don't know where you are in the world, but here at Ocean Grove, it's bloody freezing. Cloudy, cold, climate change, it's a myth. It can't be true. Because it's certainly, I mean, we're quite freezing here. But let's get started. Alright, so we're starting off with a simple cocktail. Mine are always pretty simple, but and then we're going to finish with a bit of a story, so you can have a bit of a laugh towards the end. So we'll get straight into the cocktail first. It's a coffee cocktail. Again, the base is going to be vodka and real coffee. And I'm doing a bit of a doing it a bit different. I'm using sugar syrup. Right here, sugar syrup, which I've shown you how to make yourself, and real coffee. This is percolated coffee, so as opposed to using a coffee liqueur, which is, yeah, let's make the real deal. So all right, so what we do is, it's really simple, this one. Get your cocktail shaker out, or a big glass. Straight away, we're going to do 3 shots of vodka. Let's get that in there first. One, two, three. Okay. 3 shots of vodka. 50 mils each. So that's 150 mils. Then we're going to add the sugar syrup. Do 100 mil, in other words, 2 of those. Oh, there's something. Hang on a sec. There's something in here. We're back. Okay, so we're going to do 2 of those. I wonder what that was. A bit of fluff or something. So I'm doing this for 2. This makes 2. 2 glasses, okay? So, alright, so we've added 2 sugar syrup, 3 of these, 3 vodkas. Now I'm going to add the coffee. That's 2 cups of percolated coffee. Well, I cheated a bit, it's actually out of our coffee machine that we bought at Aldi. Alright, now we just add some ice. Okay, here it is. We're in freezing cold here at Ocean Grove. I'm making an ice drink. Maybe I was born an Eskimo or something. Right, put the lid on. Now this is where usually something goes wrong. The top flies off or whatever. Give it a good shake. Oh, see what I mean? I've overfilled it. And because the coffee's still warm, it's spurting up. Give it a shake. I've got to be quick because I've got to do my story. Which is a true story, of course. All my stories are true. Now this is... Right. So what I'll do first, I'll pour it in here. And then we'll pour it in there, 2 glasses. A bit of that. 2 glasses. Who's been at my bar? I haven't got hairs that long. Alright. That's pretty much it. Now, as usual, I'll give it a taste to see what it's like. Shouldn't be too bad. Cheers. Not bad. Yeah, it's not too bad. I probably might add another sugar syrup to that. Make that 3 sugar syrups and 3 vodkas, not 2. Right, now to get on with the story. True story, when I was a toddler, we used to have this guy that lived up in the attic when we lived in Carlton, and his name was Chully. And Chully used to invite me up every... Now, Chully was a guy, imagine a 65, 70-year-old Italian, white singlet, weathered head, bald, old baggy pants, and could hardly speak any English. But he used to invite me up into his attic, where he lived right up the top, and he'd let me explore his room. Now, I found things in Chully's room like a silver pistol with a pearl handle that he had bullets for it, so it could go off. I found a sharp axe that I nearly chopped my leg off with. That's another story. There was all kinds of things. Anyway, I was up there one time, and Chully said, "Oh, look, Hattie, I have something." And he had this golf ball. And Chully's floor was quite hard. I remember it was like a very hard wooden floor. So I've got this golf ball, and I'm just playing with it, and he's reading or something over in the corner. And I'm bouncing this golf ball. Anyway, I bounced it, and it went up through. He had a skylight. So it's gone up through the skylight. So I start sooking. Chully, my ball's gone. Oh, honey, I fixed it for you. Hey, how it's gone up through there? He said, ah. So he pulls over a table, puts a chair on it, lifts me up onto the table, and he ties some string around my waist, right? Thin string. Now, this is where we get to... I've got an actual prop for this. So what he does, he ties the string around me. I'll give an example. Yeah, right. So he ties the string around my waist, like this. And imagine this is the table here. He gets me to climb up on the table, onto a chair, and then he gets up and he lifts me up through the skylight, and I'll just pretend that, so I'm climbing up like this, and he's taking in the string right. Now I'm up on a roof, we're nearly three stories up, we're 2.5 stories up, on a slate roof, overlooking Drummond Street, which is, you know, sheer concrete down below. Oops, come back. So now, the golf ball that I'm seeing has rolled down into the gutter. So he's got the string and he's lowering me down. Imagine this is the roof. And it's a sheer, about a 60 degree drop. So he's lowering me down like this. Right? Whoa. Now, I didn't go over the edge. I actually got to the edge, so I'm like this, the gutter's here, and that's a sheer drop. Across the street, I see my dad, and he looks up. He was buying milk at the milk bar. He looks up across the road, and he sees me at this angle, 60 degrees, trying to get a ball out of the gutter. Son, don't move. He starts screaming. Oh my God, don't move. And he comes running across the street. Well, by this stage, I've picked up the golf ball, and I go, Chully, pull the string. So he starts pulling the string, and I start coming back up. So now, I'm coming through the skylight, and I've still got the string on me, and Dad comes crashing through the door, up in the attic, and says, "What the fuck is going on here? What have you done with my son?" And Chully's standing here, and he's got this string, it's gone, "It's all right, Mr. Hardy. It's all right." And he's lowering, and I'm coming down, and he's actually leaning over on the table, and he's got my leg. So Dad comes rushing over. He grabs me, pushes Chully out the road. Goes, "Come on, son, come on." And he pulls me down. My little legs come down over the table, back onto the floor. So now I'm back. And Chully's still standing in shock, holding the string. And my dad is like, he turns on Chully, "Are you insane? You had him on a string. What if the string had broken?" According to Chully and myself, the string was the thing that was keeping me, you know, it was like a safety harness. There was nothing that could have happened. What could have happened? It never even occurred to either of us that the string would break from my weight had I slipped. Anyway, to cut a long story short, I got the golf ball, I was banned from Chully's room, for weeks after that. Chilly got a big, I think, a good telling from Dad how stupid he was and never to do that again. So there you go. And I'm still alive to tell the tale. Had I fallen, I would have been dead, because it would have been probably 20 metres onto hard concrete, or I might have even hit the... They had like a bit of a metal railing fence, which I would have hit that. I would have been dead. I remember looking down and seeing broken milk bottles and that as I looked over on the ground. So that's my story, true story. It's a miracle that I actually got... I was able to get back up and get through the skylight. And I think it's also a miracle that Dad didn't kill Chorley, who was a lovely guy. A bit crazy, but yeah, that's just the way things were. Anyway, cheers. Here's to the coffee vodka cocktail. Hey, now that's much better. Maybe it was the story. Thanks for watching, and... that's the end of vodka for this show. Next week we might be doing something a bit different, I'm not sure. But I hope you enjoyed it, and I've got to go because I've got to make up some potato wedges, because Ozzy and I are going to see a movie. So, science fiction of some sort. So, see you later, have a good time. I'm off.